I'm Rani Rahman. I'm the training manager here. I already working here for 8 years. So the purpose of the training, we follow the SOP of the podcast. So I want to train you about the non-verbal communication. So may I know your name?
My name is William. I'm from Netherlands.
Okay. Any working experience?
I've worked
before. And you?
Ryan from Malaysia.
Any working experience before?
A little bit of internship after university.
In which department?
Academic.
So, for non-verbal communication training, I will train you for the body posture, body gesture, tone of voice, facial expression, and eye contact. So, we have our lesson plan. The task is non-verbal communication. And objective is, at the end of the training session, you guys should be able to know the right body posture, body gesture, and tone of voice, and facial expression, and eye contact. So, to begin training, I present you the lesson plan, and the equipment, and the movement. There is no any equipment and movement. So, for this training, I will demonstrate the task. Explain about non-verbal communication. First is the body posture. Second is body gesture. Three is facial expression and eye contact. Four is tone of voice. So in the end of the trainee will demonstrate for the body posture, body gesture, facial expression and eye contact, and tone of voice. And I will ask question like, what is the body posture? I should be making a good eye contact and why. So in the end, I will summary of this training. Shall we begin?
Yeah.
So, to begin with, we have the verbal communication and this is the do. So, the first one is always present yourself with a warm smile to the guests. May I know your best warm smile? Okay, Mr. Ryan?
Okay, that's good.
Because with a warm smile, we can interact with the guests and guests will feel that our staff is very friendly because of warm smile. And the second one is always stand and walk erect, which reflects your confidence. Because we need to stand like firmly, and it will reflect your confidence with interacting people. And third one is speak in audible voice. Audible voice is like me. So the third one is speaking audible voice. Audible voice means the voice is not too high and not too low. Don't shout like this. Don't shout like this. So the next one is use simple and correct language. The language standard is English, so you need to communicate with your colleague or your guests with the simple and correct language, that is English. Because not so many people can understand with your own language, like you're from Netherlands and you're from Malaysia. So the international language is English, so it's made of people to understand what you mean. So the next one is use language that can be understood by everyone. This one is, as I mentioned before, so you use English so people can understand you, and you need to communicate with English because in our hotel there are more of guests abroad, like from Australia or Asia or something. So next, if you need to talk to your colleague in the presence of guests, talk in a standard language of communication, that is English. Because we need to communicate professionally and work professionally in our hotel. So we need you to talk to your colleague. So the next one, do not speak with the colleagues if it is not related to the business during working hour. So for example, some of my friends, they speak about something not related to business, like playing futsal, playing basketball or something. They want to hang out with friends, so do not speak in related to the business during working hours because it's not professional work. So next is body posture. As you can see, this body posture is wrong because it's the body posture is like bending the body. So you need to stand firmly like this. So the body posture is be right. Can you demonstrate, Mr. Williams? Body gesture. While you're speaking to the guests, for example, like you in the front office and then guests coming to reservation the room or the hotel, you need to have the good body gesture, like your hands do not put in your pocket or something like this. Or because there is a front desk table, so you can put your hand in the table of the front desk, so the guests cannot see either way. For the facial expression and eye contact, for the facial expression, you need to give your good facial expression, like because when guests come in, the guests want to be welcome and can see you whether it's friendly or not. So the facial expression, you need to give your best warm smile, like this. So you need to communicate with people with coming. Can you, Mr. William, can you demonstrate the facial expression? Okay, I think you need to smile. Okay, that's a good facial expression. Thank you. So, Mr. Ryan, yes. Can you show me your facial expression? Oh, you need to smile. Show your okay. That's a good question. And so for the eye contact, you need to have a eye contact when communicating with people or your guests because it is important to have your the eye contact. Okay, next. So for the tone of voice, you need to speak in audible voice. Because you need to communicate with people with good voice because when you communicate with people want to understand you, and especially when guests come in, they want to have clarify like the reservation of room or something like that. So you need to adjust your tone also. For example, when someone that's already old, they can not enough hearing. So you need to adjust your tone like high a bit your voice tone. Okay. So this is the end of the training. Thank you very much. So I will ask you some question and you're gonna answer. So Mr. Willem, may I know what is the correct body posture? And can you demonstrate?
It must be firm, straight, but bent to the to that way, then back, straight, and firm.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Willem. And Mr. Ryan, should we maintain a good eye contact and why?
Yes.
Why? Mr. William. warm smile to them. So like when you deal with them, you need to smile and hear about the complaint that from the angry customer, and then you give solution. There is, if there is no solution, you can come to your manager and ask them about the angry customer, so they can handle it.
And what if there are many foreigners come to our hotel and cannot speak English properly and cannot use the other language that we don't understand?
Oh, that's a good question, sir. So, in case of that, you need to adapt with the situation. Like, you can use your mediator to them because they can understand the languages, or we can use Google Translate. The Google Translate nowadays, the technology is already good, so we can use them to communicate with the foreigner that cannot speak English. Is there any other question?
What is the gestures you cannot do? Can you show us the things you cannot do?
So, the body gesture that you cannot do while speaking to your guests. Like sometimes many people when they nervous, they also they usually put their hands in the pocket or something like this. This body gesture means it's disrespectful for the people that they communicate with. Like it's the two example of the do not body gesture.
Any more example?
The other example is don't use your phone like this. Don't use your phone while I'm speaking. Thank you very much. Because it means disrespectful to the speaker or the people you communicate with them. And also, when you start, please do not lean back to the wall because it's not a professional work. Any other question? That's a good question. If there's no question again, can you give me a feedback of my training session?
You're doing quite great.
Thank you very much.
I think you should be more example of our topics.
Our. Okay, thank you for your feedback. I will give more example in the future. So, to summarize of all this lesson plan, so we already learned about the good body posture, like the body posture we need to stand firmly and do not bend. And also for the body gesture, we need to have a good body gesture, so it means professionally work. And for the facial expression and eye contact, facial expression, you need to give your best smile. And being eye contact with the people you communicate with them. And also for the tone of voice, you need speaking audio voice. And also you need to adapt with the situation that requires you to raise your voice or lower your voice. Also, you need to attend more training in the next 7 days because it's the SOP. And also, if any other further question, you can ask me by email that I already gave you in the lesson plan. So, may I know how you feel about this training?
I feel more encouraged because this lesson plan teach me how to react to the customers, then to show my body posture is good to the guest.
Is it benefiting?
Yeah.
So, I'm sorry.
Feeling nervous now. Because there's a lot of things to maintain while facing the guest, like all the body posture and everything. It's not something you can get used to in a short time.
But nervousness is can be removed. You need to build up your confidence more because when you already in real life work, the nervousness will be removed. Any other further question, you can ask me by email that I already gave you in the lesson plan. So, may I know how you feel about this training?
I feel more encouraged because this lesson plan teach me how to react to the customers, then to show when the requester is good to the guest.
Is it benefiting?
Yeah.
I'm
feeling nervous now. Because there's a lot of things to maintain while facing the guests, like all the word washer and everything. It's not something you...
Please, Mr. Ray, don't be nervous, because in real life work, the nervous will be removed straight away, because you are used to with the body posture release and facial expression and voice and something like that. Thank you for your feel about this training. And that's it. Thank you for coming, Mr. William.